So it used to be that skin cancer was a disease of old people, and study after study is showing that it's actually increasing in young people. One of the biggest causes probably in young people is exposure to the tanning beds, artificial tanning. When tanning first came into vogue, and we were told that, oh, these are the healthy rays, these are the UVA rays, they don't burn you like the UVB rays, therefore they're less harmful. They don't cause the skin cancer because it's this UVA. Well, actually now we know that UVA not only causes photo aging, these are the ones that leather you and wrinkle you, so that's what you're getting in the tanning bed, is accelerated aging, but they also do cause skin cancer just as readily as the UVB rays do. The more exposure that you have at a young age in these tanning beds, if you are exposed before the age of 35, your incidence or your risk of melanoma is increased by 75%. So we know that early exposure to the tanning bed definitely really accelerates and increases your risk of skin cancer, and the most deadly type of skin cancer being the melanoma. Therefore, there's legislation out there that we are working hard on. Actually, the American Academy of Dermatology has been working hard to pass legislation in states across the country to ban the use of tanning in those under the age of 18. And we're hoping that if we can bring this to the awareness of people of how harmful this is early in life and how this really increases your risk of skin cancer, that we can prevent those skin cancers. Some people think, oh, we don't want government to be any bigger and we don't want them to be involved, but it's interesting how our society has gone to government time and time again for these rules. There was a study done where people called the tanning beds and the salons to see if they would be warned against it if they were a young, fair-complected female or male. And actually, one of the number one excuses for saying it's okay was the government wouldn't allow us to do this if it wasn't safe, was what the study personnel were told kind of over and over again. And so we are looking to government for some of those safety holds. The FDA currently regulates tanning beds as if at the category of a tongue blade, so a bit behind the times, because the World Health Organization categorizes a tanning bed as a class one carcinogen, which is right up there with tobacco and asbestos.